Hi, this is Suzanne for Rainbow Loom. Today I'll be showing you how to make the Butterfly Blossoms bracelet. This is an intermediate level design. To make this bracelet, you will need 38 A colored bands, 4 B colored bands, 4 C colored bands, 4 D colored bands, and a C clip. I will be using green, pink, yellow, and purple for this bracelet. It's a good idea to have your supplies ready before you begin, so pause the video here until you're ready to follow along. Now, let's get started. Turn your loom so that the red arrow is pointing away from you. Refer to the graphic on your screen to place the first 6 bands on the loom. We'll be forming a hexagon. You start from the center pin and place band 1A. You'll place the next band directly above that, going up the left side of the loom. That's band 2A. 3A will extend to the center pin, and then we go back to the beginning of the loom. Band 4A will be placed from the center pin out to the right. Band 5A up the right side of the loom, and band 6A will pull to the center. I'll repeat this pattern one more time and then fast forward to the end of the loom. Band 1A, band 2A, band 3A. Then we go back, 4A, 5A, and 6A. Pause the video here and refer to the graphic on your screen until you reach the end of the loom. And we pull this band into the center pin. Once you've reached the end of the loom, a cap band should be placed on this last pin. Use an A-colored band, 2 fingers inside the band, turn it into a figure 8, loop it back upon itself, and place it over this last pin. Next, you'll place the butterfly wings on the loom. We'll start with this first hexagon. Use a B band, twist it to a figure 8, and place it diagonally across this first hexagon. Then we use a second B band, twist it to a figure 8, and place it going the opposite direction in the hexagon so that you form this X shape. You move to your second hexagon, use a C band, twist it into a figure 8, place it diagonally across the hexagon. And then we'll repeat this in the opposite direction with a C band to form that X shape. In our third hexagon, we'll use a D band, twist it into a figure 8, and place it diagonally across. And then do it in the opposite direction, twist it into a figure 8, and place it across those 2 pins. Now from here, we'll fast forward to the end of the loom. Now we're ready to start looping the bands. Turn your loom so that the red arrow is pointing toward you. Refer to the graphic on your screen as you loop the first 6 bands. We'll start from the center pin, pull back the cap band. We'll be looping this band. So you reach in and grab the top A band and pull it out to the left. It should form this teardrop if you've grabbed the right band. Next we'll loop band 2A. There is this band here that we'll pull back to get to the 2A band. It's the bottom A band on that pin, and pull it forward. 3A will be looped to the center. You pull all the bands above that bottom A band back and loop that band to the center. Then we return to the beginning of the hexagon, to this first pin, pull the cap band back, grab that band, it's band 4A, and loop it out to the side. 5A will be looping forward. Again, you pull all bands back from that bottom A band, and then you pull that band forward. 6A will be looped to the center. And then we repeat this pattern for the next hexagon. One A, two A, three A, four A, 5A, and 6A. You repeat the same pattern for the rest of the hexagons. We'll fast forward from here until we reach the end of the loom. And then pull this last band into the center pin. Now it's time to finish the bracelet. Turn the loom and then pull all of these bands up to the top of that last pin. Slide your hook down through the channel of that pin and then tilt your hook to the side. Grab an A-colored band, place it on the end of the hook. Pull back against that and slide back up through that channel, and then place both bands up on your hook and then move those bands to the thickest part of your hook. With your fingers, grab the band and start pulling it from your loom. If made on one loom, this bracelet will need to be extended to fit a wrist comfortably. You start with your loom with the red arrow pointing away from you, and you'll place a row of bands along one side of your loom. To extend the bracelet, you must first decide how many bands you'll need for your extension. If it's a smaller wrist, you may only need 3 or 4 bands. If it's a larger wrist, you may need 6 or more. So place those bands along the side of the loom. And then you will attach the cap band from your bracelet onto this last pin. You find the cap band on the end of your bracelet, and you place that from this last pin to the one behind it. Then you loop the single chain of your extension. Once you loop this last band, you'll pull it into the center, and that creates an area where you can attach your C-clip. You grab your C-clip with the open side facing forward and place it around those bands. Then you lift your extension from the loom. On the other end of your bracelet, you'll pull the hook away, slide your 2 fingers inside that band, and you create another area to attach the other side of your C-clip. Attach your bands to one side, place that over the other, make sure that's on securely, and then you just need to make some minor adjustments to this bracelet to get the butterfly blossoms to be uniform and neat. So once we finish that, you have your finished butterfly blossom bracelet.